Hi kids, welcome back to Faith Sprouts. I'm Miss Susanna with another lesson from the treasure of God's Word. We are going to be learning from the book of 1 Samuel. Do you remember Samuel? We learned about him a few weeks ago. He was the young boy that learned to hear God's voice and to say, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening." If we keep reading in that book of 1 Samuel, we learn about another young boy. This young boy is David. David was a shepherd boy. He took care of his father's sheep. Sheep need to be led around to find good grass, to green grass to eat, and to find water to drink, and that was part of his job as a shepherd. What do sheep say? Baa. Let me hear you. Baa. Good job. Sheep need to be protected too, because there are a lot of bigger, stronger wild animals that would love to eat sheep for dinner. So sometimes when David was watching his sheep, there would be a bear that would come and get one of his sheep. And David would use a slingshot with a rock and swing it and hit the bear. And then he would come and wrestle the bear down and take the lamb from the bear. And the bear would go away very hurt and scared. And sometimes there would be a lion that would come and attack one of David's sheep. And again, David would use his slingshot with the rock, roll it above his head, fling that rock to hit the lion and come and take the lamb out of the lion's mouth and rescue the lamb. And the lion would go away scared and hurt. David was brave and strong. But while he was also out in the field with his sheep, he was alone for a long time. And there would be nobody else to talk to and not much else to do. But what David loved to do was to play his harp and to write songs and sing songs to God. David loved God with all of his heart. This is what a harp looks like. And this is what it sounds like. Isn't that beautiful? It makes beautiful music. And David would play his harp and sing songs to God and worship God. He had a good relationship with God. One day when David was out in the field, somebody came and called for him and said, "The prophet Samuel is asking for you to come. Here is the prophet Samuel." He's older now. He's a grown older man, but he was still God's prophet for his people, Israel, and was speaking God's words. God had sent Samuel to anoint David as the new king of Israel. When Samuel got to David's house, he met all of David's older brothers, and he thought for sure that one of them was the one that God was choosing to be the next king. But God said, "I don't look at how strong or tall or handsome people are on the outside. I look inside and I see their hearts and I see David's heart." God could see in David's heart. People can't see the inside of our hearts. We only see the outside, but God can see the inside. Who we are inside, what we think, what we love, those are the things that are in our hearts. And God could see that David had a heart that loved God, that wanted to follow him and obey him, that wanted to do what was right and please God, that worshiped God and loved him with all of his heart. That's what God could see. And he said, "That's the man that I want to be the king of my people." God can see our hearts. Let's sing a song that says, "God, you are my God." It's actually words in the songs that David wrote when he was a shepherd boy out in the field singing to God. So we can sing one of his songs. It's called, "God, You Are My God." I'm going to do the signs, the actions with it, so you can follow along and you can sing with me. It goes like this. "Oh God, You are my God. and I will ever praise you. O God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you. I will seek you in the morning, and I will learn to walk in your ways. And step by step, you'll lead me, and I will follow you all of my days. Thank you, Jesus. Let's pray together. Bow your heads and close your eyes. Say, Heavenly Father, you are my God. I want to follow you with all my heart. I want to please you and live for you. I worship you. You are my King. In Jesus' name. And all God's children said, Amen. You can click the links below to find more crafts and songs and resources with this lesson. I will see you next time. I love you. Bye.